Google Tasks integrates seamlessly with Gmail and Google Calendar, but there are some pro tips you might not even know existed. So these are the top 5 Google Task tips for productivity. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a whole bunch of Google content. Seriously, it's like all Google, all the time. Recently, I made a Google Tasks tutorial video, and some of you asked some very important questions after watching that video, and I'm gonna tackle some of those questions in today's video. So these are the best Google Task tips. You ready? Then let's go. Google Task tip number 1, add tasks from Gmail. So yes, I've covered this before, but there are actually multiple ways to do this. So if you've got your tasks popped out on the right-hand side of the screen, you can simply drag and drop an email over to your task list. Or from an open email, you can click at the top to add to tasks, to add that email as a task in Google Tasks. But wait, there's more. You can also select multiple emails at once if you need to, and then select add to tasks at the top of your inbox to, boom, add all those selected emails as tasks at the same time. Plus, you can add tasks from Gmail on mobile too. So from the Gmail app, open the email that it is you want to add and select the 3-dot menu icon in the top right. Then just select add to tasks, and it's really that easy. Oh, but we're not done yet. Because you might have noticed that when you add a task from Gmail, the task name takes on the email subject line. So sometimes this is a good thing, but other times you're gonna wanna change that. Simply click on the task name to change it. Coming in at number 2 on my list of top 5 Google Task tips for productivity is to easily add repeating tasks. Ooh, this is a time saver indeed. So let's say we added a task that we want to repeat on a regular basis. We can either click to add a date and time, or we can quickly click the arrows to the right of that date and time to repeat the task. So when this is clicked, a little pop-up will appear where you can decide how often you want that task to repeat and when. So you could choose day, week, month, or year, and then you can of course pick a start date and you can even set a time for that repeated task. So by the way, this is really handy if you want to be reminded to send out birthday cards or maybe even just be reminded of birthdays on a yearly basis. This way you can just set it and forget it. Well, forget it until you need to remember it, that is, but you get the point. So once you customize your task to repeat how you like, just click on OK. So now back in the task list, we're gonna have that upcoming task shown here, but we'll also see the little repeat arrows indicating that this is a repeating task. So you might be thinking, well, what happens if I mark that task complete? Well, if we mark this repeating task complete, it'll remove itself from the upcoming task list, but don't worry, it will reappear in the task list for that recurring date that you set it for. All right, Google Task tip number 3, create subtasks. I feel like this is a really easy tip that is often overlooked when it comes to Google Tasks, and you're definitely gonna wanna take advantage of this when it comes to organization. So say you're managing a project and you're tackling something that requires a lot of steps in order for that entire task to be complete. Well, we can achieve optimal organization by creating subtasks. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a project task for this. And to the right, I've got a 3-dot menu icon. If we click on that, we're gonna have an option to add a subtask. Now here we can add our subtask that we know has to be completed as part of this project. And then we can just keep adding subtasks as necessary just by hitting enter here. And of course, you can set dates and times for these subtasks too, just like you would with that parent task at the top. All right, Google Tasks productivity tip number 4. Organize a Google Tasks list by project or even by client. So this is gonna help you stay even more organized, and it's all customizable to your preferences. So you may know that Google Tasks auto-creates a My Tasks list for you, and you may also know how to create a new list in Google Tasks. Which, by the way, if you don't know how to do that, watch my complete Google Tasks tutorial video, which is linked in the description below. So maybe you created a task list for important emails or something like that. Well, consider creating task lists organized per project you're working on, or even per client. Really think about what keeps you the most organized and then work from there. So the cool thing is that whenever you've created a task, you can always reassign it to another list at any time in the process. Just click the three-dot menu icon to the right of that task and either add it to an existing list that you've already created, or click the new list option to simply add it to a new list. And last but certainly not least, coming in at number 5 on my top 5 list of Google Task tips is to easily change the color of your Google Tasks in GCal. So that's right, every time you create a Google Task, it's automatically added to your Google Calendar if you've set either a date or time for it. It's pretty neat. So from Google Calendar, underneath my calendars, this section on the left here, you should have your tasks listed here. You just need to click the three-dot menu icon and select your preferred color for your tasks. This is going to be how all the tasks appear in your Google Calendar. And if you don't like any of these defaults, you can just pick a custom color by selecting the plus symbol here and then choosing your custom tasks color. It's really that easy. So go on, get your Google Tasks productivity on. So those are my top 5 Google Task tips for productivity. What do you think of these tips? Are they some of the best Google Task tips you've ever seen? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel. And of course, you can click here and here for even more Google content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.